teenagers have reported being cyberbullied in the last year.
Strip away the flesh and bone. Look beyond the lies you've known. Everybody wants to talk about a freak. No one wants to dig that deep. Let me take you underneath. Baby, better watch your step. Never mind what's on the left. You're gonna see things you might not wanna see. Still not that easy for me underneath. A red river of screams underneath.
I was kind of alone, that there was something wrong with me.
Stars in my black and blue sky. Underneath the depths of my sin, look at me now. Do you see? Welcome to my world.
And people always tell you, well, just rise above it, but it's not always that easy.
I knew that's what I should do, but that's not what I was able to do.
My freshman year in high school, I was cyberbullied on Instagram. Myself and a friend of mine in my English class, there was just this anonymous account that started commenting on both of our Instagrams these horrible things that you never want to hear, you never want to see be told to your kid or to your friend. It's horrible.
Cyberbullying, which is something new to all of us because we have not had this technology or this kind of bullying in our lifetime. What's amazing to me is how much damage it can do and how quickly and how easy it is now to bully.
I just blocked the account. You know, I thought that was the way to stop it, but then they made another account and I would block it and it would just keep going and going until eventually they threatened myself and my friend.
When the bullying started on Minecraft, I didn't know what to do. I started a little bit crying, even though it's kind of just Minecraft, just a video game. I felt really bad.
I was cyberbullied through my cell phone. I got a bunch of block numbers, and they were saying cool things that I will not repeat because they were so nasty.
I didn't want to tell my parents because I felt like maybe it was something wrong with me. Maybe they had a reason to be making fun of me on Twitter. Maybe it was something that I did and I deserved to be talked about like that.
You don't realize how bad it can hurt until it happens to you.
And all of a sudden I get all these notifications of these tweets that are going on and it's about me.
Kind of went upstairs and kind of felt sick to my stomach.
But it's getting so bad that it's hurting my self-esteem. And now, in the past couple weeks, you know, I've been crying all the time.
You know, I started bawling my eyes out. I didn't know what to do. I called my best friend, and she went and talked to the people, and their response was, oh, well, it was just a joke. So, you know, it can be a joke to you, but it certainly wasn't a joke to me.
I realize it's hard to take courage in a world full of people you can
through email, through voicemail, through text.
Do you think it's funny to the person that's about? It's not first-hand experience. It's not crying in my room by myself. It's not a joke. It's not funny. It's serious.
And they've proven that verbal abuse can be as bad as physical abuse.
No, people think about committing suicide, people not going to school, people switching schools just because of whatever, you know, things that people are saying.
Instead of making me angry, it made me want to not leave my house. Instead of making me fight back, it made me want to crawl into bed and ignore the situation.
I think the purpose of cyberbullying in any bully's case is to bring that person down and to make them feel awful about themselves.
and it needs to be talked about more because it is going on, it is happening behind the scenes, and there's so much of it that is not being reported.
I don't know what the answer is, except to bring a huge awareness to all of our kids and how damaging this can be.
That parents don't recognize when it's their own kids. Kids don't recognize when it's themselves.
How do we ask our kids to not cyberbully when we are ourselves as adults are doing it openly?
Kids need to know that they're responsible for their actions and that their words can hurt.
I went back on, but people were still mean. I thought I would change. It didn't change at all.
And then I started to believe it. And that's, it truly got to me. Biggest thing, especially in like teen years, where you're still figuring out who you are, and now all these people are telling you, oh, you're so ugly and fat, and you know, you can't do any of this, and they're bringing your self-esteem down exponentially.
We're putting her out there just to intentionally attack me and hurt.
I think the number one thing to do is definitely go tell your parents. You know, they might have been through this, or they might have had an experience, and they can definitely help you. I think the worst thing is to hold it inside, because when you hold it inside, it doesn't make it better, it makes it worse. And that can like tear you apart inside. So another great thing to do is to save it. When they bully you, it just shows how insecure they are. And it's not, they're trying to bring you down, and it's because they're insecure about themselves. So they have to, you know, pin other people down to make themselves feel better.